Dear friends, in this video we are going to discuss the topic intrinsic muscles of the hand. Okay, so actually this is one of the high yielding topics for the NEET exam as well as INSEAD exams, so please try to focus on this topic for the next 15 minutes. Fine. So the intrinsic muscles of the hand, that means the muscles which are confined to the hand. Okay, origin and insertion will be confined to the hand. The another name for the intrinsic muscles of the hand is small muscles of the hand. Small muscles of the hand. Okay, so remember, totally we have 20 intrinsic muscles. Totally we have 20 intrinsic muscles of the hand. Okay, out of which 15 intrinsic muscles are supplied by ulnar nerve. Okay, ulnar nerve. And the remaining 5 muscles are supplied by median nerve. Median nerve. Okay. So remember, if the question is which is the main nerve of the palm, which is the main or chief nerve of the palm, the answer is ulnar nerve, because majority of the intrinsic muscles of the hand are supplied by the ulnar nerve. Okay. So the main nerve of the palm or main nerve of the hand is ulnar nerve. Okay, that is the reason ulnar nerve is otherwise called as musician's nerve, because for playing the musical instruments, the muscles of the palm, they play very important role, which are supplied by the ulnar nerve. Okay, so ulnar nerve is otherwise called as musician's nerve. So remember this point. Okay, and I told you, out of the 20 intrinsic muscles, only 5 muscles are supplied by the median nerve. Okay, so let's try to remember the 5 muscles which are supplied by the median nerve. Okay, so by using this short form, you can remember the 5 muscles supplied by the median nerve. Okay, LOAF, LOAF. Okay, so out of the 5 intrinsic muscles supplied by the median nerve, okay, L is representing the lateral 2 lumbricals. Lateral 2 lumbricals. Fine. The meaning of lateral 2 lumbricals is first and second lumbricals. We will be discussing shortly regarding this lumbricals. So lateral 2 lumbricals, otherwise we can say first 2 lumbricals. Okay. First and second lumbricals. And what about the O, A and F and all? They are the 3 thenar muscles. The 3 thenar muscles: opponens pollicis, abductor pollicis brevis, flexor pollicis brevis. Okay, these 3 are thenar muscles. Okay, so the 3 thenar muscles and lateral 2 lumbricals are supplied by median nerve. Remaining all muscles in the palm, they are supplied by ulnar nerve. Okay, that is the reason ulnar nerve is the main nerve of the palm, also called as musician's nerve. Fine. Okay, so in this diagram you are seeing the palm of the hand, so you are able to see the 4 lumbricals, okay, numbered as first, second, third and fourth lumbricals from lateral to medial side, right? First, second, third and fourth lumbricals. Okay, we will be discussing shortly regarding this lumbricals. Okay, so we have 4 lumbricals. Then do you see the 4 muscles which are located just below the thumb? Just below the thumb. So they will be having the name of pollicis. Pollicis means related to thumb. Okay, so these are the 4 muscles of thenar region. 4 muscles of thenar region. Otherwise, you can say 4 thenar muscles. Okay, fine. And you know, this is the little finger. Laterally, we have little finger. Just below the little finger, this region is called as hypothenar region. And we have the hypothenar muscles here. Okay. So, you will be having the flexor digiti minimi, abductor digiti minimi. Then, one more muscle will be there called as opponens. Opponens digiti minimi. And one more is palmaris brevis. Palmaris brevis. Okay. So these are the 4 hypothenar muscles. Fine. And now have a look at this chart showing the five groups of the intrinsic muscles. Totally, I told you there are 20 intrinsic muscles of the hand, right? And the intrinsic muscles can be categorized into five groups. Four thenar muscles, four hypothenar muscles, four lumbricals, and we have 8 interossei muscles, 4 palmar and 4 dorsal interossei muscles. Fine. Okay. So as we studied just now, you know the 4 thenar muscles, right? Opponens pollicis, abductor pollicis, brevis, flexor pollicis, brevis, and adductor pollicis. Adductor pollicis. Okay. And I told you OAF, these three muscles are supplied by median nerve. 3 thenar muscles are supplied by median nerve, right? What about the adductor pollicis? Very, very important question actually. The adductor pollicis is supplied by ulnar nerve. It is supplied by ulnar nerve. Okay. 3 thenar muscles are supplied by median nerve, except one muscle in the thenar region, namely adductor pollicis. Remember, adductor pollicis is supplied by ulnar nerve. Okay. Ulnar nerve. Specifically, it is the deep branch of ulnar nerve. Fine. And there is one particular test for testing the adductor pollicis muscle, namely Book test, otherwise called as Frohman sign. I will be showing you the image little later. Okay. So Book test, otherwise called as Frohman sign, is related to adductor pollicis muscle supplied by ulnar nerve. Fine. Then you know the four hypothenar muscles, right? Opponents digiti minimi, abductor digiti minimi, flexor digiti minimi, and palmaris brevis. Fine. Okay. And you know all the four hypothenar muscles are supplied by ulnar nerve only. Ulnar nerve only. Deep branch of ulnar nerve. And remember the peculiarity of the palmaris brevis. The peculiarity of the palmaris brevis muscle is it is a superficial muscle. Okay. Palmaris brevis is a subcutaneous muscle. Otherwise, you can say superficial muscle. Okay. Palmaris brevis is a subcutaneous muscle, or else you can say it is a superficial muscle. It is located just beneath the skin. Okay. So that is otherwise called as panniculus carnosus. Okay. So the question may be, which of the following is an example for panniculus carnosus? That means, which of the following is a subcutaneous muscle or superficial muscle? And the answer is palmaris brevis. Okay. So remember, since it is a superficial muscle, it is the only muscle in the palm supplied by superficial branch of ulnar nerve. Fine. The only muscle in the palm supplied by superficial branch of ulnar nerve is palmaris brevis. Remaining all muscles will be supplied by deep branch of ulnar nerve. Fine. So now coming to the lumbricals, there are four lumbricals, right? They are numbered from lateral to medial. Fine. Out of the four lumbricals, the lateral two, that means first two lumbricals are supplied by median nerve, and medial two lumbricals, that means third and fourth lumbricals, are supplied by deep branch of ulnar nerve. Fine. Then what about the intraossei muscles? We know there are four palmar intraossei and four dorsal intraossei. Okay. So all the 8 intraossei muscles, 4 palmar, 4 dorsal, all are supplied by ulnar nerve only, deep branch of ulnar nerve. Fine. So now this is a very commonly asked image based question. Okay. So they will be labeling any one particular muscle among these four muscles, and they may usually ask what is the action of the marked muscle, what is the nerve supply of the marked muscle. Any idea about the four muscles you are seeing here? Yes, these are the four lumbricals. Okay, these are the four lumbricals. Fine. And right now I am marking the four tendons of flexor digitorum profundus. The four tendons of FDP, flexor digitorum profundus. Okay. And all the four tendons of the flexor digitorum profundus, they give origin to all the four lumbricals. Okay. So you will be knowing this is lateral side, this is medial side. Okay. Because this is the thumb, which has only two phalanges, isn't it? Okay. So this is the little finger. Okay. So which is lateral, which is medial? In this image, you will be able to understand, isn't it? So now tell me, out of the four lumbricals, this is the first lumbrical. I am marking as L1, fine. And this is L2, okay. Second lumbrical, and this is L3, and this is L4. I have already told you the lumbricals are numbered first, second, third, fourth from lateral to medial, isn't it? Okay. So as you see here, all the four lumbricals, they have origin from where? All the four lumbricals, they have origin from the four tendons of the flexor digitorum profundus, fine. And as you see here clearly, the L1 and L2, the lateral two lumbricals, okay, they are unipinnate muscles, isn't it? What about the L3 and L4? The third and the fourth lumbricals, they are bipinnate muscles, okay, bipinnate. You can clearly understand from this diagram, isn't it? Fine. Now, as I told, the first and second lumbricals are unipinnate, and the third and the fourth lumbricals are bipinnate, okay. And what about the insertion? All the four lumbricals, they have insertion into one particular structure called as dorsal digital expansion of the fingers, okay. Otherwise called as extensor expansion of the fingers. Extensor expansion of fingers, okay. Dorsal digital expansion, otherwise called as extensor expansion of the fingers, okay. And the nerve supply is the very commonly asked question related to the lumbricals. L1, L2 are supplied by median nerve, that is lateral two lumbricals. What about the third and fourth lumbricals? Yes, the medial two lumbricals are supplied by ulnar nerve, fine. And coming to the actions of the lumbricals, you know, lumbricals are crossing the three joints, metacarpophalangeal joints and interphalangeal joints, isn't it? So the normal action of lumbricals is flexion of the metacarpophalangeal joints and extension of the interphalangeal joints, fine. Okay. Any idea about the applied aspect of the lumbricals? If there is paralysis of the lumbricals, it will lead to one clinical condition, one deformity called as, yes, yeah, claw hand deformity, isn't it? Claw hand deformity. The claw hand deformity is otherwise called as main end griff or griffy deformity, okay. So this may be asked, okay, instead of asking as claw hand deformity, the question may be main end griff deformity is due to paralysis of, what is the answer? Yes, it is due to paralysis of lumbricals, mainly lumbricals, and also paralysis of interossei muscles also, okay, mainly lumbricals, okay. So can you tell me what will be the position in case of claw hand deformity? What is the position in case of claw hand deformity? If you know the normal action of the lumbricals, you will be able to see what will be the position of the hand in case of claw hand deformity. You know the normal action of lumbricals is flexion of MCP joints and the extension of IP joints, right? So now this condition is due to paralysis of lumbricals. So the normal action of the lumbricals will be lost. So there will be extension of metacarpophalangeal joints and the flexion of interphalangeal joints in case of claw hand deformity. You can see in this diagram. Okay. So this is the claw hand deformity. Okay. Otherwise called as main end griff deformity. As we studied, it is due to paralysis of lumbricals mainly and also due to paralysis of interossei. Okay. So the metacarpophalangeal joints will be what? Extended or hyperextended, whatever. And the interphalangeal joints will be flexed. Okay. So that is the position of the hand in case of claw hand deformity. Fine. So there are two types of claw hand deformity. One is partial claw hand deformity. Another one is complete claw hand deformity. We know out of the four lumbricals, two are supplied by ulnar nerve, two are supplied by median nerve. So only if there is combined injury of median nerve and ulnar nerve, you will get complete claw hand deformity. Okay. That means all the four lumbricals will undergo paralysis, right? What about partial or incomplete claw hand deformity? It is only due to injury to ulnar nerve. Only ulnar nerve is getting injured, and the usual site is fracture of the medial epicondyle of the humerus. You know, just behind the medial epicondyle of humerus, ulnar nerve is running. So if there is fracture of the medial epicondyle of humerus, ulnar nerve will get injured, so that it will lead to partial or incomplete or ulnar Clahan deformity. Fine. So medial two lumbricals only will undergo paralysis, leading to clawing of the medial two fingers. Fine. Now let's talk about the interossei muscles. Okay. So we know totally we have four palmar interossei and four dorsal interossei, isn't it? Four palmar and four dorsal interossei. Why they are called as interossei muscles? Because they arise from the metacarpal bones. They arise from the metacarpal bones. And please remember one very common important point about the palmar interossei. Totally we have five metacarpals, isn't it? So the four palmar interossei arise from various metacarpal bones except third metacarpal. Okay, except third metacarpal bone. Third metacarpal does not give origin to any of the palmar interossei. Fine. And what about the insertion? Similar to the lumbricals, all the interossei muscles, they are also getting inserted into the dorsal digital expansion of fingers. Fine. Nerve supply, we know all the eight interossei muscles are supplied by deep branch of ulnar nerve. And what is the action of the palmar interossei? You will be knowing the mnemonic, isn't it? Palmar interossei, P representing palmar interossei, it will cause adduction of fingers. Adduction of fingers. Okay. Okay. In this diagram, you can clearly understand the palmar interossei muscles. These are the four palmar interossei muscles. Okay. Arising from the various metacarpals except third metacarpal. That's what I told. Third metacarpal does not give origin to the palmar interossei. Okay. And when this palmar interossei contract, it will cause adduction of fingers. Other fingers will be moving towards the middle finger, towards the middle finger. Fine. Okay. And what about the dorsal interossei? I told you, you can remember as pad, palmar interossei cause adduction of fingers. Similarly, the action of dorsal interossei muscles is DAB, D-A-B. That means what? Dorsal interossei cause abduction of fingers, abduction of fingers. The other fingers will be moving away from the middle finger. Fine. So this diagram you will be able to understand, showing the origin of palmar interossei muscles. Okay, from all the metacarpal bones except third metacarpal, isn't it? So one important thing about palmar interossei, they are not attached. They are not attached to third metacarpal bone. Okay, and middle finger. Okay. So middle finger is already in the midline. So there is no adduction movement required for the middle finger. So this is a very important point. Palmar interossei muscles, they are not attached to the third metacarpal bone and the middle finger. Fine. Yes. Now, can you tell me which muscle is causing the movement you are seeing in the first diagram? Yes, dorsal interossei. Okay. So what is the movement you are seeing in this diagram? The other fingers are moving away from the middle finger, isn't it? So the movement you are seeing here is abduction of the fingers. Abduction of fingers caused by dorsal interossei, isn't it? And in the second diagram, which muscle is involved in the second diagram? Yes, the other fingers are moving towards the middle finger, isn't it? So that is palmar interossei causing adduction of fingers. Palmar interossei causing adduction of fingers. Pad, P-A-D. Fine. Now, see this diagram showing the dorsal interossei muscles. Okay. So, you might have noticed in this diagram, all the four palmar interossei muscles are unipinnate. They are unipinnate muscles. Okay. Unipinnate muscles. Isn't it? What about the dorsal interossei? All the four dorsal interossei are bipinnate muscles. Bipinnate muscles. Okay. bipinnate muscles. As you see here, they arise from the adjacent sides of all the five metacarpal bones, isn't it? They arise from all the five metacarpal bones. Okay, insertion is similar. They are getting inserted into the dorsal digital expansion of fingers. Fine. Okay. Now see, the test which is used for testing the palmar intraossei is called as CORD test. Okay. So if the patient, if the person is able to hold the CORD or paper tightly in between fingers, that means the adduction of the fingers is proper. Okay, intact. So that means we are testing the palmar intraossei. Okay. So CORD test is for testing the palmar intraossei, and obviously the nerve tested is ulnar nerve. Fine. Deep branch of ulnar nerve. Okay. And the second diagram is showing the test called as Egawa's test. Here also ulnar nerve is only tested. Okay. And the muscle tested here is dorsal intraossei, because the patient is asked to abduct the fingers. That means moving the fingers away from the middle finger against resistance. Okay. So that means dorsal intraossei is tested in second diagram. Okay. So take care of this image based things. Okay. Yes. Now, any idea about the test you are seeing here? This question has been asked in the last NEET exam. Okay. NEET PG 2021. This image based question has been asked. Yes. This is the pen test. Okay. This is the pen test. And the question asked was, which nerve is tested in this image, in this test? Like that the question was asked. So the test here is called as pen test. Okay. So pen test is for testing the abductor pollicis brevis, APB muscle. Abductor pollicis brevis, one of the thenar muscles supplied by median nerve. Okay. So please take care. Pen test is for testing the abductor pollicis brevis muscle, which is supplied by median nerve. So as you see here, the movement you are seeing here is abduction of thumb. Okay. The patient is asked to abduct the thumb, isn't it? In order to touch the tip of the pen. Okay. So called as pen test. Fine. Take care. And any idea about this image based question you are seeing here? Yes. The name of the test here is called as book test. Book test. You can answer which muscle is tested in this so-called book test. We have discussed already. Yes. Book test. Adductor pollicis muscle is tested. Adductor pollicis muscle is tested. Okay. So if the question is book test is for testing which nerve, what will be your answer? Yes, you know, adductor pollicis muscle is supplied by ulnar nerve, deep branch of ulnar nerve. So take care. Book test is for testing the adductor pollicis muscle. The nerve tested is ulnar nerve. Fine. So what is so-called book test? Fine. See here, this is normal actually. Okay. This is normal. When you ask the person to hold the book in between thumb and the index finger, okay, that is called as book test. Okay. So if the adductor pollicis muscle is normal, intact, okay, you will be able to see that thumb is extended. Okay. So thumb is extended normally. This is normal. Okay. But in condition called as Frohman sign positive, okay. Frohman's sign positive. If there is positive Frohman sign, there will be paralysis of adductor pollicis muscle. Adductor pollicis muscle will undergo paralysis. So obviously due to injury of which nerve? Ulnar nerve injury. Ulnar nerve injury, adductor pollicis muscle paralyzed. So there will be positive Frohman sign. That means when you ask the patient to hold the book, the patient will be using the flexor pollicis longus muscle in order to hold the book between the thumb and the index finger. FPL muscle will be used, okay, which is supplied by median nerve, which is supplied by median nerve. Okay. So please take care of this one. Fine. Called as book test. And finally, I have told you already, the all the four lumbricals, then four palmar intraossei, four dorsal intraossei, all are getting inserted into one structure called as dorsal digital expansion, isn't it? Otherwise called as extensor expansion of the fingers, isn't it? So I want you to know few details about this dorsal digital expansion, otherwise called as extensor expansion. Okay. Any idea about the formation of the dorsal digital expansion? It is formed by the four tendons of which muscle? Extensor digitorum muscle. Okay. So the dorsal digital expansion is formed by the four tendons of extensor digitorum. Okay. Four tendons of extensor digitorum. Fine. And as we studied, this dorsal digital expansion will give insertion to which muscles? All the four lumbricals and all the eight interossei muscles, the four palmar and the four dorsal interossei muscles. Okay. So this question has been asked. Okay. So take care. The question is, all the following muscles are related to the dorsal digital expansion except. So what are the three muscles related to the dorsal digital expansion? Extensor digitorum, which is forming the so-called dorsal digital expansion, and lumbricals and interossei muscles, which are getting inserted into the dorsal digital expansion. Okay, fine. That's the end of the today's discussion. Thank you all for your patient listening. Thank you all.
Best training, peaceful environment, PG medical entrance exam preparation were my expectations. I got them at Speed Medical Village in Kanchipuram. Today, I'm a PG topper.
Speed Medical Village, a unique eco-friendly campus dedicated for PG preparation. Speed Medical Institute, a complete solution for medical education.